Airway management is the process of maintaining ventilation in a patient by using an artificial airway. This ensures that gas exchange can occur by establishing a link between the patient and the ventilator, which is important because we need to make sure that the patient's upper airway is free and clear of foreign substances so that air can flow into and out of the lungs. This is an important topic for respiratory therapy students, which is why we created this video to help by breaking down a sample TMC practice question on this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. A 63-year-old female patient is orally intubated with a size 7 endotracheal tube and is receiving ventilatory support. While attempting to suction the patient with a size 12 catheter, you note that it cannot pass beyond the tip of the tube. Which of the following is the most likely cause of this problem? A. There is a kink in the tube. B. The tube is in the right mainstem bronchus. C. The suction catheter is too short. Or D. The suction catheter size is too large. Do you know the correct answer? Well, let's break it down. After reading the question and answer choices, first, we must determine if the right size suction catheter is being used. A quick and simple way to do so is to double the ET tube size and then make it the next size down. For example, the question tells us that the patient has a size 7 endotracheal tube. So now we can double that number to get 14. Then we need to take the next smallest catheter size, which would be a size 12. This confirms that a size 12 catheter is the appropriate size for a size 7 endotracheal tube. So now, looking back at the answer choices, this means that we can rule out C and D automatically. In general, whenever you are unable to pass a suction catheter down the ET tube, it usually indicates that there is some type of obstruction. And the most common types include mucus plugs, kinking, or when the patient is biting the tube. Even if the tube is in the right mainstem bronchus, you should still be able to pass the suction catheter beyond the tip of the tube. So by reading the question carefully and using our knowledge of endotracheal tubes and suction catheters, we could determine that the correct answer has to be A. There is a kink in the tube. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. Again, it really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Well, what'd you think about these practice questions? Was it helpful breaking them down in a simplified way? I hope so, and as I always say, definitely try to go through as many of these as possible when preparing for the TMC exam. Even if you don't use our practice questions, this is still a strategy that I recommend for all students. However, if you do want to get access to all of our premium practice questions, definitely consider checking out our TMC test bank. You can still take advantage of the temporary promotion that's going on by using the special link below. Also, if you want to get these practice questions and explanations sent straight to your inbox on a daily basis, you can consider signing up for our Practice Questions Pro membership, which costs less than one of those fancy cups of coffee that all the kids are drinking these days. It's truly never been easier. All you have to do is sign up and we'll send the practice questions to your email address each and every day. Small tidbits of knowledge over time can add up to huge results. I'll drop a link to that as well right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.